All right, hey YouTube, Kenny here again. Beer review, beer review, beer review. This one I'm actually really excited about. As you've seen on this channel several times now, I've done plenty of Firestone Walker. Great brewery out of California. I need to go try and visit you someday, I feel like. But this one caught my eye just based on the beautiful green, pink-looking can. They promise hints of kiwi, leche, and fajita. So, Firestone Walker, what do we got? Very light colored. That's refreshing. Luponic Distortion, number 15, Firestone Walker. That is very refreshing. It's a damn fine IPA, I feel like. IPA series, so number 15, huh? 5.9% alcohols by volumes. Very light. But yeah, this one I really like. So this one supposedly, from what I think I read on the box, you're supposed to get notes of kiwi and other kind of fruity tropical flavors, you know, without the addition of any fruits. It's all done with different types of hops to try and create this flavor profile, which I think is really unique and different. And you know, I think they did it to a degree. I think they got there.
What do you think, Kat?
He's over there hanging out. Whoops. So I don't know. I don't know what you people watching, if you've had this one, what you think of it, if you think they've kind of got it. I think it's just a damn fine, good IPA. Very easy to drink. Very light, crisp. Yeah, I'm very excited about it. What do we got here? Luponic Distortion brings together Southern Hemisphere hops, all from New Zealand, that produce a beer that bursts with tropical notes. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty good as far as that goes. Pretty easy on the palate with light tropicalness. Yes, sir. I like it a lot. Number 15. It's the first time I've heard of it, so obviously I don't get to participate in a whole lot of Firestone Walker up here, but I'm sure California also doesn't get to partake in a lot of stuff that Minnesota has to offer. And that's fine. We should definitely share. Hopefully it'll be easier to share once all this stuff is done, COVID stuff. But yeah, this is darn fine. As you can see, I'm quickly making short work of it. Man. Yeah, this is something different. I definitely need to go visit these guys, because this website, maybe I'll put this one up in the link below, but this one has a whole lot of information about this one. I think it's absolutely just... It says 4 years ago, Firestone Walker released its first beer in an ambitious rotating IPA series. With its Luponic Distortion series. Each release features the same base beer, but uses different hops each time, is what brings you back for this release. Okay, cool. I'd be very curious to drink more of this style, or this series, rather. I really, really, really dig it. It's great. But this one's really fun. So this review might not be very beneficial to a lot of people, because this one might not be around very long. And this one was canned... I can't really make it out. 7.73? I can't really tell what it is. It doesn't taste bad. Damn fine beer. Hopefully this microphone setup works pretty good too. I've been trying this out for a while now, and editing wise it sounds really good. Don't get a lot of the busy traffic noise. Cat's in hanging out with us for another beer review, so that's good. Hopefully there's still plenty of these types of days left in Minnesota. Sure makes living here wonderful. Winter sucks, but this is good. Days like today are great. Yeah. So, what else can I say about it other than it being incredibly delicious and you might not be able to get it anytime soon. I don't know. It might be hard to get for a lot of people unless you happen to see this video and go, hey, I saw it at the store. I need to go grab that right now. But you should definitely try their beer regardless because it's really good. Whoops, wrong tube. All right, so I think I'm going to wrap this one up. Damn fine beer. Super easy to drink. Sorry I didn't provide a ton of information on it. I think if you like a good, light, but very flavorful IPA, but still has plenty of IPA-ness. I said it again, right? No, this one's really good. You should definitely check it out. It's a very good, light, easy drinking IPA that would be fine on a nice evening like tonight or a nice hot day too. Ah, delicious. But thank you for watching. Hit that like button if you like these videos. Subscribe for more weekly beer review videos for me. Maybe I'll have to up it to 2 videos a week or something like that. I don't know. We'll see how this goes. But thank you for watching, everybody. Take it easy.
Cheers.